assisted the pummeling part of it. That was your hips over to the inside, underneath the elbow, and shift your hips.
Move on. cross grip. Knee. Break. Hips up. Reach. Head. Extend your back. Bring your leg up. Up your leg. Now you're bringing up. Number three. Grab his wrist. Underneath, you're gonna grab your arm. If my arm is level like this, I might be able to lift your elbow. Shift your hips. Push his arm out to that pocket so you can push his hand towards your hip. Now four. Going for the hip hold, sweep, he holds. Frank, I'm gonna put his stomach or nose. This and then try to get my frame. Okay. From here, set my frame because that's going to keep him away as I go over my side.
Okay. And that frame is creating a space for you. Okay. Any questions on those four setups in the Williams Arc? If you're going to have trouble remembering them all, find one that you feel like you're comfortable doing and just drill it. Okay? It doesn't matter if it's just pummeling. Okay? If it's just this, get used to doing this. Hold this posture. Move. Williams Arc. If you feel comfortable just doing one side, that's okay. Just do one side. If you feel comfortable doing both sides, go ahead and do both sides. Whatever you want to do. Okay? So, if you want to do all four, run through, do the first one four times and you switch and then keep going, okay? So do first one four times, second one four times, third one four times, fifth one four times, okay? Or just pick one and drill. Okay? Alright, hands up.
One, two, three.
Now we're in the few scenarios for the trying track. And the first one was they start pushing off the ground. So I immediately bring my knee up in front of the shoulder. Okay? Once that happens, I bring my leg, my heel, over his other shoulder. Now I can bail on my grip, because this serves as a frame. Here, he's trying to push into me. My knee is a frame there. Okay? My heel is biting down this way and down this way a little bit. Okay? Like that. That makes it easy for me to pull my leg out and lock the triangle trap. Just trying to track. That was the first scenario. Second one was if they have their arm over your leg and they're still kind of driving into you. Okay. So what we did there when we shook her leg. Okay. Frame stays nice and tight. Shake your leg. They have to be putting pressure on you. If they're hanging out there, you're not going to do this one. You're not going to try to pull your knee through. Okay? Yeah, if they're pushing at you, if he puts his hand down, that was the first one. If he's just kind of pushing at you a little bit, shake your leg, come through. Back into the plant position. Okay? Plant position. He's hugging your leg this time because he knows triangle's coming. Okay? So, four. Your hand on his four fingers at least, slide it straight away. Don't try to pull it out this way. Slide it straight up to go against the shoulder muscles. And either once you're here, you're just out and around this way, or straight. If you want, if you can, you can retract your leg, but I recommend just going around the world. Here. Third one. Let's see, shake one, and then there was bounce one. How many can we do? One, a shake. Oh, just the different movements in the triangle trap. So we're here, boom. Either you retract, or retract, or you pivot. Okay, just come underneath, pivot your little arm leg around, and then try to keep your knee on that side of their head. And lock your feet. You don't have to worry about locking the triangle, but the weight across your feet is important.
So a choking leg, a leg that would choke in a triangle over the top. Okay. So you have those few options into the triangle trap. One, they push. Feed that immediately. Use that angle. Lock that and bail on your grip. So you're gonna retract or square your hips up. Two, we're just kind of heavy there, but they're still putting pressure into you, so you vibrate your leg. Vibrate and open with your frame a little bit. Same thing.
Push.
Going into the submissions first. Okay. So let's practice that getting into the triangle trap. I'll do that a few times. Okay. Pushes. Just here. You can start up here or get into here every time. Right? The cues are he pushes, or it's this one, or he doesn't push, but he's still kind of pushing into you a little bit. Shake your leg. Open this. You have to have counter pressure. Bounce your leg. He's trying to do this. Yeah, he's trying to do that. Immediately, you're doing this. So now it doesn't matter. He pushes into me. I'm flat on my back. That's okay. I still have everything I want.
If they're, I don't know for whatever reason, I'm trying to think like, so if I'm feeling it and they're just driving me, and I try to put themselves up straight, but they know that I'm just trying to get away from the triangle trap or whatever, would I then fight for the pressure and just try to hit around so I can bring my leg up?
So,
can you do it from the side?
Are you saying, so right here you're talking about them just driving into you?
Yeah, because they're just trying to, because they know that you're trying to put that.
Yeah.
Layer.
Yeah. So, you obviously don't want to be on your back, you want to be on your side. So, the second that happens and you don't feel like you can go to the triangle trap, it goes, yeah. If I'm here and I feel like he's just going to push into me and I'm losing it, I'm standing slow. Yep, going ready to apply. Okay. Any other questions? Okay, so try those. Try to do it as much as you can from memory. And then we'll go on to the submission series from there. Okay, hands up. 1, 2, 3. Over the top. You're doing it live. So I'm always holding this. Whenever you're here, you're holding the posture always. Okay. I'm going to try to start attacking this arm or triangle or more. Right? So, in a second here, I'm going to have to let go of this posture. So, the reason why having this over the top is going to hold this posture. So, here, hips up, get my arm on the inside. Here. And now is when I have to let go of the posture, so I do that plant thing with my legs. If I'm this way, the wrong way, but here in terms of posture, he's not posture. And I can't really attack anything. If I'm here, I pull my heels down, squeeze my knees in. Where I let go in terms of posture, I'm not going anywhere. So I'm not like that the whole time. I'm not doing that, squeezing everything tight and burning myself up. My legs are just relaxed here, and then when I bring it, let go of this head, that's when I'm going to play. Then you break their grip. Okay. So once you break their grip, you're here, boom. Top hand slides down the top of his wrist. Rear naked choke his arm. Okay? This hand is just over the top of his wrist. Over the top of my bicep. Unlock your feet. Shift your hips out that way. Relock your feet. Turn your body for the floor. If you're there and he starts straightening his arm, that's okay. If you can manage arm crush, arm lock, good. If not, back it all the way over to here. Go back to his head. Okay. Grab your shin, flip the hip. Right away, you're going to scoot straight back. Okay, just shoulder walk straight back. Arm, push your knee. lock your knee or lock your arm as straight as you can get, okay? So if you have trouble doing that, just move your body away so my arm's straight and I come back. Walk, walk, walk. Here. Knee comes north, over the top, point our toes up, and then turn. If we're here, so I have the Kimura, I got the triangle. I have the straight arm lock. If we're here, you can start posturing, right? Grab this thumb, turn this thumb straight up. Okay? Thumb goes straight up, back of his hand is on my chest. Move his hand to the same side that, you know, his shoulders. Okay? Push it. If maybe that's not working, you're trying for it, it's not working. That leg comes over in front of everything. It's a tight arm. But that one's only if you're extended. I can't really get much more. And you just lock it here. One more time, broken. Triangle trick. Hold posture. Find the space under your butt. Good. Clamp. Okay. Pull. Heels down. Heels tight. Open your arm. We're going to get you up your arm. Grab his wrist. Shift your hips. He straightens his arm. By catching on time. Awesome. You're going to press up. If not, boom. Cross. Grab his posture right away. Okay. Here. Grab my shin. Foot in the hip. Shoulder over, shoulder over, shoulder over. And on the knee, stiff arm. All the way stiff. Boom. Knee comes north. Over the top. Point the toes. Try. If you're trying, you know this, you start posturing. Boom, boom. Grab his thumb. Turn it. Palm up. Side to side. Forward. If that's not enough, leg that's on the same side as arm. Comes over the toe. Squat the bird. Straight on the toe.
Google Flat.
That's kind of, I was gonna say that's kind of Brendan written all over.
Okay. Any questions on that series? It was kind of a rapid fire thing, but most of us have been here for it. And if you have any questions, just ask. Go through them slow. Okay. Hands up. 1, 2, 3. You're not going to go for that one. If you don't posture, like if you're just hanging out here, I'm not going to be like, get this over and everything. So they have to posture for this one. Okay? You know, even if you're looking to get a triangle, you don't have to go for this one first. You can do this one first if you want. Grab this, come here, lock it out. But they have to. There has to be that space.
What else?
Okay. We're just going to use the bicep this leg to so my hips high. You know, if I have this leg relaxed, I'm trying to do either the knee of that or my hips sink and I'm not going to be behind an elbow. So when you do it, this bites down to keep your hips loose as you come over. And you know, you can just open your knee a little bit if you wanted to. You want your foot to hit there. You don't have to come over like this. But you can just be there and then lock the elbow. Okay. Work them around. Any other questions?